Hello, my dear little children. Before we start today's class, let me ask you, do you go out often? Do you go out with your parents to the nearby supermarket or to your cousin's house? And how do you go? Do you walk or do you travel by some vehicles? Vehicles are used for moving from one place to the other place. And can you name some vehicles that we travel? Yes, tell me. Car, okay, scooter, bus, etc. Very good. How many of you have a cycle? Or anybody who rides a cycle at home? And tell me, where do you go for cycling? To the playground or on the road? Good, so you do go cycling. That's nice. You can see that some vehicles move on the road, some move through water, and some vehicles move through air. Children, today we are going to learn the three different means of transport or modes of transportation. Transportation is the movement of people and products or things from one place to the other place, and for that we use vehicles. We talked about the vehicles that move on the ground or on the road. This is called land transport or road transport. In land or road transport, the vehicles move from one place to the other place on land or road. Let us learn the names of different means of road transport or the vehicles. This is a bicycle. How many wheels does it have? Two. Correct. Bigger children ride on their bicycle to school. Riding a bicycle is a good form of exercise. This is motorcycle. It has two wheels. So how many wheels does a scooter have? Two wheels. Does it ride on roads? Yes, it does. What is the name of this transport? Say again. Scooter. These vehicles can carry two people comfortably. The name of this vehicle is auto rickshaw. Have you ever noticed how many wheels it has? It has three wheels. There is a driver who drives this vehicle, and three people can be seated comfortably in this. This is a car. How many wheels does a car have? Yes, four. This is a van. It carries more number of people. It is usually bigger in size as compared to a car. Like the car, it has got four wheels. Some children use vans to go to school. Another four-wheeler, like the van and car. Can you name this road transport? Jeep. What is the name of this road transport? Yes, it is a bus. Some children go to school in school bus. Most of the people use a bus if they need to go to work or some other place. The bus driver drives the bus. By the way, have you seen a double-decker bus? Here it is. This is a truck. It carries heavy things from one place to the other. One can also see special vehicles on road, like the ambulance and the fire engine. Why is it special? Because the ambulance carries sick people to the hospital and the fire engine reaches in time to put out the fire. Now children, another form of land transport is the rail transport. What is this? This is a train. It runs on special rail tracks. These can carry a large number of people and goods at the same time from one place to another. The train is suitable for long journeys. This is metro. You must have traveled in them, right? It carries many people within the city limits. So children, you know about the land transport now. In the next class, we will learn about water and air transport. Okay? See you in the next class. Bye. Dear parents, there is a worksheet in which you have to guide your child to color the land transport and circle the rail transport. Thank you.